Now a play fake here on first down. Sliding up, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Steven Weatherly in there to get him. It's a loss of five.
And they get to him right out of the gate. And this defense hoping that that's a harbinger of things to come.
Yeah, when you give up a first play sack, makes your quarterback wonder if he's going to go to the sidelines and talk with his offense coordinator and head coach and say, hey, you know that game plan we put together? We might need to change it right now. Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20-point score gives yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, he's got a man complete. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A big play that time through the air. 30 yards.
We see this happen so often. If you're a defender, it's like watching a bad movie over and over. The pressure's good, forcing the quarterback out of the pocket. But it's a lot to ask for these defenders to stay plastered to receivers long enough. And sure enough, they let a man come open, and the connection leads to a big play.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. The numbers for Freeman a week ago. 12 carries, 89 yards, and a touchdown.
And even though it's a short week, running backs love when they're in a groove, and that's exactly where he is right now. He's hoping to feast a little bit more here on Thanksgiving.
Dancing to his left.
As a rookie quarterback, that's exactly how you endear yourself to your teammates. Give it up for the cause. It's also how you end up on the training table, too.
Yeah, it's a catch-22. Coach doesn't like it. Teammates love it. Where do you fall on it?
Well, I fall on wanting to endear yourself to your teammates, but pick your spots. Be smart about it. They need you for the full season.
Yeah, the rookie's going to learn as he goes.
And Charles, despite this list of key inactives that we see here, they've obviously still been pretty successful.
Give everyone credit for this one, because to me, when that happens, key guys are out, the next man steps up and plays well, but that starts with the organization itself, all the way through. No excuses for guys being out, finding guys who are capable back.
Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted, torn back across his body. Picked off by Micah Hyde, and the Bills are going to take her. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
Now this is Hilton on the receiving end. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. A big connection on that one. 30 yards.
One of the things that led this organization to commit to him as a starting quarterback as a rookie, his ability to keep his eyes downfield and make plays out of the pocket. Able to see the receiver while on the move and complete a really accurate throw.
This is Freeman on first and 10. A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves him with a 2nd and 3. Pretty effective run there, and now they can start to smell that end zone.
Pound the rock. Make sure you use your O-line to set the tone of dominance and physicality, and pound the rock.
A nice throw there for the first down, and this is a big moment for this young man under center. You know, he's had a few months now to get acclimated to life in the NFL, but you got to think, a little extra pressure here, right, CD? I mean, you're getting the start on Thanksgiving in front of the national audience.
Especially since you and I both know he's watched this game since he was, what, 4, 5, 6 years old and dreamed of playing in it. In fact, his family sent us some of those videos of he and his family in the backyard playing their Turkey Bowl games themselves. So now he's gone from the backyard to the big stage And here he is.
The reception good for 7. It's 3rd down. That's now 4 completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked up by Jordan Poyer. And the Bills. The offense set to take the field here as they have the football in the final minute of this first quarter. The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. And he's got it up over the 40 to the 41. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. They'll run on first down. It's Freeman. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11. No score after 1 on EA Sports. Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And he's got a first down as the tackle made at the Bills 28.
That was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
Back to throw now on first down. He's got it to Hilton. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
When the hitch route is run really well, that jab step off the line of scrimmage by the receiver, which is designed to back up the defender and give him a little bit of space, all you want there, get that space, catch the football, and then make a move and pick up extra yardage. And that's exactly what he got done there.
And the Lions are going to be set up with a 1st and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line. Here we go now on 1st and goal. They'll run here with Freeman. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. They give him 5 that time as they draw a bit closer here for a 2nd and goal. They'll try to run this one in. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. A great play there. His 9th touchdown of the season as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon.
In as many coaches' meetings as we sit in, we hear the word finish all the time, don't we? And on that play, the back actually finished getting into the end.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They come off a victory over the weekend, but now the quick turnaround here for this Thursday night game. How does that affect how teams like this approach these short turnarounds?
Well, wins and losses always factor into, you know, how you're getting ready for the next game. But equally as important when you have the short turnaround, what is your injury situation? Are you losing key guys? And if so, how well have the backups prepared for this? Because you don't have much time to get them ready. They have to be ready before this week in order to play well in this game.
And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up 3rd down. Escaping the pressure right. Finding some room at midfield. And he is going to have a Lions 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. On 1st down, Freeman. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 46 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. He'll look to throw. Flush to his right. And he slides to avoid the hit.
close to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit, because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws in his windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now. They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked up by Jordan Poyer. And the Bills are going to have the football. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
On second down, Freeman. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
This is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
And here's a throw that's taken in by the tight end, Cook. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 47. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Going up top. And it's a leaping effort, but it's knocked away and incomplete. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard line of the 30.
They need it right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
They go play action here on first down. He gets this one to Boyd. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield, because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
Give him a gain of 5 on the completion, and that'll make it second down. They're going to look to throw. Buying time to his left. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. They'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's third down. And now a 10th carry for Freeman. And he has the first down before he's tackled at the 5. This offense, number 1 in the NFL in picking up first downs, and the run game got him another one there.
A really good stat to lead the league in, isn't it? Because if you keep picking up first downs, sustaining drives, that means you're controlling the football, controlling the clock, and letting your defense rest on the sidelines.
To the goal line, but it's incomplete. Intended receiver there was Quintez Cephas, but it'll be second and goal. A give, the first man through, Gillespie of the fullback. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. A great effort there. His second touchdown on the season. And the Lions are able to extend their lead. CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience.
Offense ready to kick off their next drive. Still more than a minute to go, so you know, there is time if they want to mount something here.
Not only time, but they have 3 timeouts at their disposal as well, so that changes everything that you're doing here. Without those timeouts, you can only work the sidelines hoping to get out of bounds. Here, the middle of the field is still available because you can call timeout and regroup.
second and 10. He'll look to throw again. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Running right, this is Freeman. Freeman to first down and more. And he's got room. And finally brought down at the 43. 94 yards rushing now for the NFL leader coming into this ballgame.
I don't care what anyone says. To me, it takes a little bit of intestinal fortitude to call a running play in this down and distance. I mean, you're talking third and 10. And sometimes the angles line up really well on a running play.
Caught him totally off guard, obviously.
I think you catch him in some pass drops, and now you're able to fire out and get some space and create it for your runner and let your blockers get a good approach attack on the defenders.
This is caught by Hilton. And they're going to have a first down, and they're in field goal range as well as they're down inside the 20. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. They'll throw now on the final play. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. So we're at halftime here in the annual Thanksgiving game in Detroit. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks so much. We'll get back to you and Charles in Detroit in just a moment. But first, let's take a look at what's following our two games later today. Plenty of good matchups in that 1 o'clock Eastern window. It'll be noon at Soldier Field in Chicago, and a big test for the Bears, as they'll have to contend with the New England Patriots. Later in the afternoon, a lot of the country will be watching the game at Lambeau Field in Green Bay, where it'll be the Packers taking on the New York Jets. And lastly, we'll all be tuned in on Monday night for what should be a great one between the Las Vegas Raiders and the LA Chargers. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. The Lions in the lead, and they're going to get the football first as well as the second half is underway. Taken at the goal line. And he returns this to the 22. Third quarter starts with a run by Freeman. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
And when the defense wins and gives up no yardage on a running play, that's something they can build on and carry themselves forward throughout the game.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Cook. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. A little too much extracurricular there.
When you have a game with a lot of contact, tensions are going to run pretty high. You're going to be emotional, but you have to harness it somehow. And he didn't on that play.
After the penalty, here's Freeman. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and 6.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. But Charles, in the past, a lot of people called this offense one-dimensional.
I think you did.
Well,
I think it was you.
I'll be honest, I did. I think the fan base is hoping with this young rookie that they can put some wrinkles in this offense like we just saw.
I think you're exactly right, because we did have that discussion that what we've seen in the past from them, they needed to broaden, and they have done it here. Look at what he's bringing to their offense. And now, as a defensive coordinator, you've got some extra work to do to prepare for him and their offense.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. He's got his man. It's caught for a Lion touchdown. A great play there with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Lions take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Detroit offense ready to begin their drive.
A good balance attack for that last touchdown drive they had. Now it's time to see if they can do that again.
And it really becomes a tale of two play callers, doesn't it? The offensive guy, he's in sync. Everything is working pretty well for the defensive guy.
What's going on the defensive side?
That's a tough one because he's prepped all week as well, and he can't get a bead on exactly what they're doing right now. What he needs is one of his guys just to make a big play and disrupt things.
Here's a 2nd and 7. And this is Cook with a grab.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
They'll look to throw now on 1st down. He gets this complete to Cephas. Now he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a 2-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
And after getting tackled, he's still down and looking very slow to get up.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6.
We'll check on his status when we get back. Now I think we're going to get a timeout here. Yes, a timeout here, as it looks like we've got a lion that's shaken up. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break.
And defensively, going with a dime set, 6 DBs on 3rd and 4. They'll look to throw. Fighting his safety valve here. That's complete. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. They'll get only a yard out of that, and it'll bring up 4th down. They'll set up to throw, eluding the pressure right. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. A 1st down carry here for Johnson. And he'll work this forward for about 3. It's 2nd down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Lots of praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5. Now McCoy, his 1st throw since coming in. Flushed out right. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
Now McCoy. And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. T.Y. Hilton with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Lions add on to their lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
They are just putting things together so well here, drive after drive. They really have captured the momentum, haven't they?
They've taken momentum and pretty much not just give them a jersey.
A fight for it, and this is caught. It's caught indeed. A big play there for Detroit.
When they needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver it. As this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent and sometimes spectacular.
So So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Now Freeman, he's been busy today. Tackle made there by Matt Milano.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Oftentimes when you're losing a game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. And they took that opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he is going to have a Lions first down. He needed 5. He got it barely, as it will officially go down as a gain of 5 yards. So first and 10. And if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
Gets it forward for 4, maybe 5, but the flags fly. And this one could be coming back.
Everyone tries to keep their hands inside when they're blocking ever since they liberalized the rules where you can extend them out. But sometimes they get out a little wide and they get detected grabbing some cloth.
A fight for the football and it's intercepted. Tre'Davious White with a pick. And the Bills are going to have it here just past the 25. First and 10 coming up as this offense takes over possession of the football in the third quarter. They'll run with Freeman here to begin the drive. He'll rumble for about 6 up across the 20 to the 22.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Hands it off out of the gun. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. Here on Thanksgiving Day. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Lions on third down. They've hit on 6 of their 8 tries. Very good. This time they face a 3rd and 2. They run from the pistol here with Freeman. Yeah, Freeman was trying to work his way forward, but I don't think he got there. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a 4th down. Here comes the Lions punter now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the 4th quarter. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. That'll go as a punt of 42, 7 on the return. And the Bills will take. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Now there are 2 scores on the plus side. Still time here in this 4th quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
Charles, you said the magic number was probably right around 20 for this defense because they're facing one of the top 5 offenses in the league in terms of points scored. They've had their moments, but this offense, just a little too good, isn't it?
They really are, because no matter what you do to make an adjustment on defense, they've had an answer for it.
And he'll be out just 1 or 2 shy of the 30.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
And down in 15 he goes. 135 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the 4th quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
That hold coming from the middle of the line, the center.
And it's difficult for him because sometimes you've got people right over you, and as soon as you snap it, trying to get your hands up and block them, you can be a little bit late getting it done.
And he's got his man. It's caught for a Lion touchdown. A great effort there. His 10th touchdown of the season, second of the game.
And the Lions are looking to make it two straight as they add on to this fourth quarter lead. So that drive there, CD, a good response, and that might be the one that gets them to the finish line, a comfortable lead.
Yeah, and that's all about not letting the team back into a game because they just gave up a touchdown.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. A 20th carry now for Devontae Freeman. And he'll wind up with about six up past the 30 to the 31.
4 yards remain for second down.
Freeman again. Calling a gain of three, but not enough to move the sticks. It'll be third and about a foot or two.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from blocking.
Scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They'll hand it off, Nixon. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
The last run got a couple here. Second and 8. Again, it's Johnson. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Brandon, unfortunately, I've been here before. They've had two opportunities to stop them, so this is demoralizing. They haven't gotten it done. Now you're calling all your blitzes, all your attack defenses, but you're not worried about playing your normal position. You're going to take chances now.
Well, you said it. Two third down opportunities to get off the field. Couldn't do it, and the clock continues to roll. The last run got six. Now second and 4. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Lions in possession of the football as we welcome you back. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. And able to fight forward inside the 15 to the 13. And now right out of the 2 minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. So they come up on second down. If they can get another run like we just saw, we'll likely put an end to this thing. And here he'll get it down to the 7. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause of the action. A timeout here defensively. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. They'll try and run. This is Johnson. Halfway, 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4. The Bills are going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. And they'll try the jet sweep here. And he'll get it down close to the goal line, but not quite in. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal. They'll run it with Johnson. Nothing doing there as the 13th play of the drive proves to be unlucky.
This is a long drive offensively. Wouldn't you hate to end this with just 3 points?
Doesn't it feel like during a ball game you have certain narratives going on and there's certain drives that seem to take on just a bit more importance than others? This feels like one of those, doesn't it? To me, 3 points here.
Charles, we saw a lot of points go up in this one. Certainly defensively, stuff that they can look at on film, don't you think?
No doubt about it. And they've got to go back and check where the errors are, how they're going to fix them,
and continue to get better at what they do, but they also need a little adjustment with their confidence. To give up that many points, even if you win a game, that can hurt you.
So for the Lions, they continue to keep pace for that first round bye as they move to 11-1. And they'll get the weekend off now as they get a little extra time to prepare to face the Chicago Bears. Meanwhile, for the Bills, their luck may have run out as they fall to 4-7 now in the year. And they'll look to get back in the winning column next week as they head to Foxborough to face off against the New England Patriots. So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. It's a win for the Lions as we say so long from Ford Field.
Benefactor's benefactor. Well, truthfully, we know you never been a factor. Well, honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got them boys about to mass up. Lectures from the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on rap a lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot. Listen, I went and got my digits up. Listen, your favorite, bruh. You don't want no trouble, cuz the 25th, I got a meeting with the governor. That's real rap a lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip up in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, nope, he not. The mind to a praying woman. The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me. Red Dog has caught me slipping with the wailing on me. I went to calling out for Jesus like a reverend, homie. Chalked it up to sin, took it on my chin. Gotta take some L's if you wanna win. They took a but then take a sin. I didn't even have no re-up I could re-up with. Had to rob another just to re-up. Pray to God it in his heart he find forgiveness for me. It was nothing personal, it was just business for me. When I got on, I paid him back and told him it was ugly. I'd rather ask forgiveness like 100 times than be asking for permission in a beggar's line. Cause of who I be and check out how I tender mine. I got a partner who don't eat no poke at dinner time. But let you act like you gon' ever hurt an injured mind. He have your woman
heaven, that's my good of time. I keep my eyes on glory till the devil get behind. Now bear in mind, the devil made me offers I decline. We not aligned, not combined, I am not confined to any wicked system that these demons have designed. They frame a mind and have you salty as a bacon rind. I'm trying to mastermind how to help out humankind. I'm open mind, but I do not rock with none aligned. My state of mind is to keep a peace for peace of mind. I'm like Malcolm with my peace at the Venetian blinds. I'm trying to manifest some things in my subconscious mind that I have only seen in dreams in my unconscious mind. My dreams unrefined, spring to mind, a state of mind that make it seem this lucky life of mine is pre-designed. And if it is, then thank the Lord, cause that's the mastermind. This love, this love, this love.
Back again up in this entertaining for you. Come for my M's, you get this double double. Fake to your bubble in this game because I love the trouble. So watch your tone if you don't want to rumble. You pop pop like my, did you forget we know you're not with any inch of the real real? So stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that loud ooh. Jitty jitty bang, jitty jitty bang. Oh, them cannons ring, yes, them cannons ring. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same. Having some fun, why you out on your run? Taking victory laps, I'm in the hood with them ones. Catch me out in Decatur with some meat and potatoes. Waffle House in Atlanta, I hit the blue flame later with them two-tone gators, who you know gon' face. I see them keep trying, professional imitators. Rep, where's the flag? Now you're making me mad. With 47, get that. You better get back. You pop, pop, like my, did you forget we know you're not with any inch of the real, real. So stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that loud ooh. Jitty, jitty, bang, jitty, jitty, bang. Oh, them cannons ring, yes, them cannons ring. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same.
Tables and turn. Forget the bridge we done built. It's time I let them all burn.
They tried to kill me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I bring in paper, paper, paper from the first to the first.
They count me out. Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling. They count me out. It all begins
right now.
Catch me if you can.
Total catch up.
But I still can't even see them from the view. Got my check up. And now I'm trying to blow a bag of two.
Proud to shoot.
Designer, drink it what I desire.
Put him out,
what I told him, cause that boy he on fire.
Walk in that thing and air it up, and in my bag a little bit.
Remember my pockets in a jar, I couldn't put a little chick.
They say they truly love his paper.
You see that's a meal. That's why you catch all my brothers balling and shooting no bricks.
Hold up, check me out.
Hold up, I think the tables and turn. Forget the bridge we done built, it's time I let them all burn.
They tried to kill me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I bring in
paper, paper, paper from the first to the first.
They count me out.
Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling. Count me out. It all begins
right
now. Catch me if you can. Never really care what they say.
On God.
Only ever care about one thing.
Ching, ching, ching.
chain, cha-chain, raquets, raquets.
Hit the bank.
Ba-bang, ba-bang, put you in your play. Wait, they done got me started. Without me, it's not a party.
No.
Ma, he got it rocky. We bring havoc to your lobby. Tristan, he got shoddy. They gon' copy cause we poppin'. Blues up in my wallet. If I like it, then I cop it.
Hold up, check me out.
I think the tables done turned. Forget the bridges we done built. This time I let them all burn.
They tried to kill me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I
bring
it
paper, paper, paper from the first to the first.
They count me out,
yeah, yeah. Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot, sizzling.
Oh,
they count me out,
nah, nah.
It all begins
right here,
right now. Catch me if you can.
I'm ready for more.
If you fired up, I'm fired up.
Don't run from rap.
1, 2, 3.
Hey. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. Game time. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. Yeah. I just got 20, I'm running on empty. There's more where that came from, my money is silly. I feel the envy, not trying to be friendly. It is what it is, if you want me, come get me. Whenever you ready, no, I keep it steady. Yeah, I get the W, throw the confetti. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of gorillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take it. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war.
I'm ready for more.
Whole squad in the field, yeah, we
tell them I'm ready for more.
I'm ready for war.
Tell them I'm ready for war.
If you looking for me, you know where to find me. I leave you dusted, I leave you behind me. I flip the switch from 0 to 90. If you do too much, I'ma do the almighty. You know I got it, you know I'm a legend. You know I'm the one, I do not come in second. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of gorillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take it.
I'm ready for more.
Tell them I'm ready for more.
I'm ready for war.
Tell them I'm ready for war.
I'm ready for more.
Tell them I'm ready for more.
I'm ready for war.
Tell them I'm ready for war.
Look, I played the game, I missed a shot. I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finesse, for not, my not, my not. For Lexin', I fell out and cut the check. My not, my not. Paralyzed the set, but I bet I've been taking hits like I can die like innocent. Morning of the day, the dawn of the dead day. I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chop and I chop it. The neck of the surfer, determined, the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping and run. Popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances. I'm gonna stay in Atlanta. Most of them move to LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand, the colors are mixing.
can do it better than he can. Really like that, no pretend. Had to get him back just to revenge. I'ma go to Paris for the weekend. I'ma go with it for the weekend. Sports mode, cause I be speeding. No safety, I'm bleeding. I can never fumble like defense. Going hard for my sisters. Hurry and take my picture. Heels hurt, I got blisters. Touchdown, make me richer. I ain't even hungry, but I ate that. I keep on winning and they hate that. And they hate that. And they hate that. And they hate that.
Yeah. What's up?
Eat 'em up, yo.
Yeah, I was on a little diet. Had to get ready for the summer. Even if they don't want it, we're going to give it to them.
Eat 'em up.
Till I need another pin.
Gotta make the right decision, no, it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see is good intentions, it's for clout and haters, man. You can never be yourself, you carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up, trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearrange. Moving careful every day, exactly how I play this. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm placed. Feel like Jesse Owens, cause I'm taking off. Put the metal to his mouth, retain his tongue, hold the braces. But I'm all about the beast until the sucker hit a make. Oh man, eat man, your performance kinda shaky. I'm prepared for the fame, I like that crap, so I'm really
today, from Ford Field in Detroit, it's week 18 of the NFL. Lions taking on the Minnesota Vikings.
First opened in 2002. There's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, the Motor City. Both teams emerging from the Ford Field tunnels just a short time ago. And, of course, the loudest cheers were reserved for the hometown Lions. They're set to go as they will match up with the Minnesota Vikings. Along with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, we look at this Lions team. Nothing on the scoreboard. 0-0 as the offense gets ready to take over the football. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Pressure coming from the Vikings, and they get there and bring him down. Randy Gregory. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him. They'll look to throw here. Escaping the pressure right. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. A little glimpse of his athleticism there and what they're going to have to deal with. He can use his legs to dance around back behind the line of scrimmage and beyond the line of scrimmage.
And wouldn't you love to get a copy of their defensive scouting report going into the week? Because that's been stressed the whole time. Keep him bottled up. Keep him in the pocket. But it's the first drive of the game and emotions are running high. Someone forgot that, trying to make a big play and gave up a bigger one instead.
Got it across the midfield stripe and into Viking territory. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to convert on third and short yardage with a gain of 4. These two teams matching up for the second time this year. Their first meeting back in October, week 6, and it was the Lions who got the road victory in that one, so they'll be looking to claim the season series now here at home in Detroit. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. Now a hand on him, and this time not quite to the 30, it'll be down at the 31-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. Back to throw. He completes it to Boyd. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6. Second down at 4. Back to throw here. Flush to his right. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Danielle Hunter. Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10. Play number 9 now on this pretty long opening drive, but this is 3rd down. They'll set up a throw. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up 4th down. Seibert able to knock this one through. And the Lions are going to take a 3-0 lead. So this offense will head back out there, already in excellent field position thanks to the interception. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He finds his man complete. It's Boyd. And this will be a gain of 6 when it's all said and done. Down to the 15 from the 21. Now here's a handoff out of the gun. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
They'll drop to throw. This is caught. That's good for a gain of 6, 2nd and goal.
That's tough to play zone defense when they can just curl up right there in front of you.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we can talk about finding the soft spot defensively. How do you make sure they don't find the soft spot like they did? And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. Philip Dorsett, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Lions are able to grow their lead.
If you didn't know it, it won't surprise you to find out that this team leads the league in scoring. They've been a quick strike team all season long. There's another example. They did it again. This offensive coordinator, right now, you can write his ticket towards being a head coach. He's advanced in the ways of offense.
Lions offense ready to kick on drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, 2nd and 1 yard from the 34. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And to the 42-yard line here on there.
But the they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. And I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Now he's flushed out right. Give him a scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, not much there that time. And I think we were both wondering, once he got out of the box, whether he just throw the ball away and he winds up only picking up a yard or two.
On second down, it's Freeman. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy. A lot of running backs, a little bit of a disadvantage when you start talking MVP. Might not be the case that he's got a shot, don't you?
I do. I think he's got more than a shot. But what he's going to need here down the stretch this late in the season, he needs that big closing game, that game that we're all going to reflect on and go, oh, my goodness, did he put up a number, let's say 200-plus?
And he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the first down marker. They'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down. Now back to throw. This one taken in by Cephas. And they're into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings' 24-yard line.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your and scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
On first to throw, steps away to his left. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. He'll get 3 yards on this at second down. 10-3 our score out here on EA Sports. Second and six. Now that second and seven. Looking to, and he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10.
But he's certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They've got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting, being aggressive, and making plays.
Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. And this is certainly not what you want to see in the final week of the year. We'll be back. Second and three. He's got his man. It's caught for a Lion touchdown. Jared Cook, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Lions are able to extend their lead.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. They have to be pleased with the way that they moved the football thus far.
And why wouldn't they be? Two touchdowns on a field goal in their first three possessions. They're playing so well right now, the field goal probably feels like a disappointment.
And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
Well, it's hard to have vision as a runner and find a hole when there's nothing but defenders in your way. They stacked that one up really well. But give him credit. Instead of trying to bounce it out and turn it into a big play, which might have turned into a big loss, kind of just took his medicine there and took the 1 yard.
And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Devontae Freeman. And able to get this way up to about the 46-yard line. A good run, got seven on first. He'll drop to throw. His throw incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you?
Absolutely, just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. Caught left side, it's Beckham. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. Here's Corey Bohorquez now. He punted four times last week as he gets this one away here. A call for a fair catch, and it's made at about the 23-yard line. Not good at just 24 yards there. So So now this offense will take over, and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Be complete to Cook. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Certainly worth noting, he's now one catch away from 600. He's at 599 in his career. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And a dangerous throw there, incomplete. He threw that into coverage. It was nearly intercepted. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second. Over the middle, taken in. And they'll get it up just short of the 44. They'll look to throw again. This is caught. It's Bourne. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Another good throw there in what has been a strong season to this point, Charles, as he now has surpassed the 3,000-yard mark with that last completion.
And just think, he's been forced to learn on the job here in his first year. Normally, veterans talk about, hey, I've got the answers to the test before the game even begins. But this guy's taking the test with every throw, with every game. And so far, he's passing with flying colors.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Now left side on the swing pass, and he gets it inside the 10 to the 9.
So many times in my career I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing, but as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
And it is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. Quintez Cephas, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Lions add on to their lead.
And remember, partner, that's a rookie quarterback back there. Apparently, he's getting the hang of this NFL thing pretty quickly.
And three touchdown passes. You're right, he looks comfortable. What are they doing? Anything in particular?
Well, they keep talking about making.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offensive sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And they get it down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
There's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. That reception, his 600th NFL catch. Congratulations. Quite the accomplishment. He'll look to throw. Over the middle to Mack. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25.
This has been a nice to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Again, he'll drop to throw. He finds his man complete. That's Boyd. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second two. Only needing 2 yards on second down. Back to throw again. And brought in by the tight end, Cook. And the Lions are going to have a first and goal as he'll be taken down at the 7-yard line. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. So we've reached halftime here in Detroit with the Lions out on top. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. We'll get back to you and Charles in a minute. But first, time to give the folks at home a look at what's going on around the NFL. We'll start with the oldest rivalry. Chicago playing host to Green Bay in the NFC North. And it's the Packers who have the lead in that one. The Packers seem to be on their way to what would be a good victory. From there, we head down to the Sunshine State to check on the Jaguars at home in Jacksonville. And they have the lead over the visiting New York Jets. Trevor Lawrence with a couple of touchdown passes there. Finally, let's get right to the center of the U.S. map and check in on the Chiefs at home in Kansas City. And they have the lead in that one over the visiting Indianapolis Colts. Patrick Mahomes looking good. Two touchdown passes. Meanwhile, in our game, no shortage of offense as each team has been able to move the ball effectively. Will the defenses show up in the second half? To find out, we give it back to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, thanks as all. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. Both these offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring us as we are underway in quarter three? No run back here to begin the half, and we will start at the 25-yard. So this offense will head back out there, already an excellent field position thanks to the interception. Back to throw now on first down. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Second and 10. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he's dropped right into three. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
Now they go screen. It's complete. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Well, this one complete downfield on the left side. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. Now, after the completion of timeout, an injured player. And this is certainly not what you want to see in the final week of the year. We'll be back. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. It'll be a gain of five there as they move closer. It's second and goal. When we talk about being on schedule, I think they're on schedule after that run, getting it right down there on the doorstep.
Maybe even a little bit ahead, because now the defense can't dictate with pressure. They're guessing about where you're going to go.
And he's going to take it in for a Lion touchdown. Devontae Freeman. His 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Lions are able to grow their lead. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude of the group that's behind.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Eluding the pressure. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Xavier Woods with a pick. And he'll bring this one back to the 29. A young quarterback, Charles Wright. I know he's right. Is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL.
So So the football will be at the 25-yard line. Offense gets set to take over. The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
And oh, he's unable to hold on to that defensively. A potential game changer, but it falls incomplete. They come up now 5 following the incomplete pass. And this hookup, it's complete. And they're going to have this across and inside the 45.
This offensive game plan has just been sensational. I mean, when you think about all the different ways they've gotten their receivers open so far, it's really been impressive. Scheme, design, execution.
Freeman a first down and more. And down to the 27-yard line. 69 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
He's obviously a bit of a shorter running back. Sometimes when he goes up the middle like that, he gets lost in himself for 10, 20 yards.
I actually asked NFL line crew, do you actually some of the smaller running backs?
And in for the Lions, touchdown. His 9th touchdown of the season. And the Lions are able to extend their lead.
Having a rookie quarterback taking time to adjust to life in the NFL, because this guy looks like he's been doing it for about, what, 7 years? 4 touchdown passes? That's not something rookies are supposed to be doing with the ease in which he's doing it.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And this will wind up the Lions first down as he gets this up past the 30.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
He'll look to throw. He finds his man complete. That's Boyd. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available, because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
So they'll run it here on the jet sweep. Trucks over him. And he's got it across the midfield stripe and into Viking territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4. They run. Devontae Freeman. He'll get about 4 here. Down to the 43-yard line. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there. Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been 4 down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, so if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
Now a man open down the middle of the field. Third quarter of action. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So from the 17 now, here's a 1st and 10. Now it's Freeman. And he's eaten up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten a yard down to the 16.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority, because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Well, this drive's taken more than 3 minutes off the clock already as they come up on second down. Flushed out right. Dorsett's got it. And this carry terminated at the 8-yard line. Good stick skill showing the power, but just not much room to operate. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. And he's got it. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the one.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play. And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. Devontae Freeman with touchdown number 15 on the year and second of the game. And the Lions look like they're going to get back in the win column as they extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Trying to bust out of that losing funk, and these fans have to like it. This offense will head back out there, already in excellent field position thanks to the interception. This is Freeman on first and 10. And he'll get four there, down to about the 12-yard line.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one.
102 yards for him now on the ground as he goes over the century mark here. I'd say he's ready for the playoffs ahead, no doubt.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he...
And he'll get in zone. Touchdown. Good effort there. Touchdown. And the Lions stretch this fourth quarter lead even further, and they are on win of the season.
They're definitely a good day in the football. Very good days. Down passes there at all.
Yeah, and so much for going in.
Ready to begin their drive. Here for them that this is the week they're going to put it all together and end that long lose. They're not home yet, but in control in the fourth quarter. Give them first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. But for both, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
They go to Freeman again on second down. No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves them with a 3rd and 3.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game, and while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
From the gun, he'll hand this off. 2 yards on the pickup there. It's 4th down.
This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost like no man's land. Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space, maybe too far for your field goal kicker. I'm like the old rule. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Possession is 9/10 of winning the game. Go for it. Get the first down. Close it out.
They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and the Vikings will take over here, 1st and 10. And now out comes Mel.
Both offenses have been clicking in this one. A lot of points on the board. We'll see if that trend continues. They'll eat some clock with Freeman. And he'll work this forward for about 3. It's 2nd down. the fourth quarter here. They've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36. Now I think we're going to get a timeout here. Yes, a timeout here as it looks like we've got a Lion that's shaken up. The Lions on third down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This will be 3rd and 6. And this is certainly not what you want to see in the final week of the year. We'll be back. And he is going to have a Lions first down as he's able to get 8 yards there on 3rd and 5. So the Lions in possession of the football as we welcome you back. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beat. Probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage.
You got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a 2nd and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to 3rd and manageable with that run.
Hands it off out of the gun. Just a 1 yard pickup there, and it'll be 4th down.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
inch of the real, real. So stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that loud. Ooh, jitty, jitty, bang, jitty, jitty, bang. Oh, them cannons rang, yes, them cannons rang. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same. Having some fun, why you out on your run? Take them in the hood with them ones. Catch me out in Decatur with some meat and potatoes. Waffle House in Atlanta, I hit the blue flame light with them two-tone gates. Who you know gon' face? I see them keep trying, professional imitators. Rep, where's the flag? Now you're making me mad. With 47, get that. You better get back. You pop, pop, pop. Like my, did you forget we know you're not with any inch of the real, real. So stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that loud. Ooh, jitty, jitty, bang, jitty, jitty, bang. Oh, them cannons rang, yes, them cannons rang. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same.
Shall come forth as pure gold. Have you been tried in the fire? Have you been tried in the fire? Well, tell me, did you come through as pure gold?
You kick it like the benefactor's benefactor. Well, truthfully, we know you never been a factor. Well, honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got them boys about to mass up. Lectures from the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on rap a lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot. Listen, I went and got my digits up. Listen, your favorite, bruh. Listen, you don't want no trouble, cuz. The 25th, I got a meeting with the governor. That's real rap a lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip up in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, nope, he not. The lying to a praying woman. The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me. Red Dog has caught me slipping with the wailing on me. I went to calling out for Jesus like a reverend on me. Chalked it up to sin, took it on my chin. Gotta take some L's if you wanna win. They took a. But then take a sin. I didn't even have no re-up I could re-up with. Had to rob another just to re-up. Pray to God it in his heart he find forgiveness for me. It was nothing personal, it was just business for me. When I got on, I paid him back and told him it was ugly. I'd rather ask forgiveness like 100 times than be asking for permission in a beggar's line. Cause of who I been, check out how I tend to mine. I got a partner who dinner time. But let you act like you gon' ever hurt an injured mind. He have your woman. And that's my dinner time. I keep my eyes on glory, tell the devil get behind. Now bear in mind the devil made me offers I decline. We not aligned, not combined, I am not confined to any wicked system that these demons have designed. They frame a mind and have you salty as a bacon rind. I'm trying to mastermind how to help out humankind. I'm open mind, but I do not rock with none aligned. My state of mind is to keep a peace for peace of mind. I'm like Malcolm with my peace at the Venetian blinds. I'm trying to manifest some things in my subconscious mind that I have only seen in dreams in my unconscious mind. My dreams unrefined, spring to mind, a state of mind that make it seem this lucky life of mine is pre-designed. And if it is, then thank the Lord, cause that's the mastermind.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yeah, tell me out.
I think the tables done turned. Forget the bridges we done built, it's time I let them all burn. They tried to count me out, well now it's the word. I bring in paper, paper, paper from the first to the first. They count me out, now count me in. Oh, I'm hot, sizzling. See him from the view, got my check up, and now I'm trying to blow a bag of two. Proud of shoot, and all designer, drinking what I desire. Put him out, what I told him, cause that boy, he on fire. Walk in that thing and air it up, and in my bag a little bit. Remember my pockets in a jar, I couldn't build a little chick. They say that Trini left his paper, you see that's a mill. Why you catch all my brothers ballin', ain't shooting no bricks. Hold up, check me out. Hold up.
ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war.
Back again up in this entertaining for you. Come for my M's, you get this double, double. Straight to your bubble. In this game because I love the trouble. So watch your tone if you don't want to rubble. You pop, pop, like my, did you forget we know you're not with any inch of the real, real. So stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that loud, ooh, jitty, jitty, bang, jitty, jitty, bang. Oh, them cannons rang, yes, them cannons rang. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same. Having some fun, why you out on your run? Taking victory laps, I'm in the hood with them ones. Catch me out in Decatur with some meat and potatoes. Waffle House in Atlanta, I hit the blue flame later. With them two-tone gators, who you know gon' face? I see them keep trying, professional imitators. Rep, where's the flag? Now you're making me mad. With 47, get that. You better get back. You pop, pop, like my, did you forget we know you're not with any inch of the real, real. So stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that loud, ooh, jitty, jitty, bang, jitty, jitty, bang. Oh, them cannons rang, yes, them cannons rang. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same. Ooh, jitty, jitty, bang, jitty, jitty, bang. Oh, them cannons rang, yes, them cannons rang. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same.
Shall come forth as pure gold. Have you been tried in the fire? Have you been tried in the fire? Well, tell me, did you come through as pure gold?
You kick it like the benefactor's benefactor. Well, truthfully, we know you never been a factor. Well, honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got them boys about to mass up. Lectures from the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on rap a lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot. Listen, I went and got my digits up. Listen, your favorite, bruh. Listen, you don't want no trouble, cuz. The 25th meeting with the governor. That's real rap a lot, no. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip up in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, nope, he not. The mind to a praying woman. The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me. Red Dog has caught me slipping with the wailing on me. I went to calling out for Jesus like a reverend on me. Chalked it up to sin, took it on my chin. Gotta take some L's if you wanna win. They took a. But then take a sin. I didn't even have no re-up I could re-up with. Had to rob another just to re-up. Pray to God it in his heart he find forgiveness for me. It was nothing personal, it was just business for me. When I got on, I paid him back and told him it was ugly. I'd rather ask forgiveness like 100 times than be asking for permission in a beggar's line. Cause of who I been, check out how I tend to mine. I got a partner who don't eat no poke at dinner time. But let you act like you gon' ever hurt an engine mine. And that's my dinner time. I